Communication Workers of America, Alliance for American Manufacturing, BioGreen Clean, and the iSafe team bring you this Ed Schultz news and commentary Monday through Friday. I don't know if Bernie Sanders is ever going to get the respect of any high-level broadcaster across this country when it comes to someone actually admitting in commentary that Bernie Sanders could run the table and make this happen. I think that there is a tremendous amount of pressure on broadcasters across the platform at every network to not go too far with the guy that advocates breaking up the big banks on Wall Street, that wants to go after corporations to pay their fair share because they're parking money offshore, that would purport the idea of paying for college educations for Americans at state universities in every state across this country, expanding Social Security, not cutting it, also going for universal health care. All of these things poll in the majority of Americans across the board. So how is Bernie Sanders an out-of-the-mainstream candidate? How is he left-wing? The fact is, we are a center-left country. And what it comes down to is that people get so down at the mouth that they don't vote. And what Bernie Sanders said in Minneapolis at the DNC meeting over a week ago, that the turnout is what it's all about, holds true for Iowa and New Hampshire. And if Bernie Sanders wins one or two of those states, or both, it could be a rough road to hoe for anybody who jumps into the race. Put the Hillary Clinton email scandal or trustworthiness poll aside. There are differences when it comes to trade. There are differences when it comes to big oil. There are differences when it comes to health care. There's no question about it. That's one thing Hillary Clinton doesn't talk about, universal health care or round two of Obamacare. That is where Bernie Sanders has been all along.